Hello, welcome to Evincing Academy. We are discussing the another session of coordinate geometry. And in coordinate geometry, we have discussed last classes Cartesian system, the quadrant, the position of the points, where any point lies, whether in first quadrant or second quadrant or third quadrant or fourth quadrant. And we have also learned that coordinate of origin is 0, 0. Any point lie on x-axis, their y-coordinate is 0. And any point lie on y-axis, their x-coordinate is 0. Now, we will try to learn the distance formula today. What is the distance formula in coordinate geometry? So let me describe today, start with the distance formula. Distance formula. What is distance formula and how to deal with this? In a Cartesian system, suppose this is x-axis and this is y-axis, as we have discussed this, and this is x-axis and y-axis. If P be any point, P be any point whose coordinate is x1, y1, it means y1 is this length is y1, and this is x coordinate origin. Where x coordinate is x1. So x1, y1 are the two points. The another point is Q, and the coordinate of this point is x2, y2. So this distance is considered to be y2, right? Y coordinate is distance parallel to y-axis, and this distance is described as x2. So if this distance is x2, this distance is x1, so the distance between these two will be x2 minus x1, that is x2 minus x1. If this distance is y2, if I draw a perpendicular, then this distance will be also considered as y1, and remaining distance can be considered as y2 minus y1, that will be the distance. If this is x2 minus x1, so that will be also x2 minus x1. And this distance is described as x2 minus x1. Now suppose one has to calculate the value distance between PQ. So this is P, M, I can write here. This is N and this is R, I can write. So PQR, in triangle PQR, in triangle PQR, one can write hypotenuse square, that is PQ square, is equal to this is PR square plus QR square. PR square plus QR square. So PQ square is PQ is equal to under root this is PR square plus QR square plus QR square. And PR is nothing else. What is this PR? PR is x2 minus x1 whole square. x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. That is PQ. And what is PQ? The distance between P and Q. So this is a formula which you need to learn. The distance between two points P and Q. So this is a formula. What is that? If P, x1, y1 and Q, x2, y2 are any two points, are any two points in a plane, then distance between them can be calculated like PQ is equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the formula, and this formula is called distance formula. You must remember this in mind. Now, if suppose one point is at origin, then what will happen? The other corollary, you can say here, corollary is, if one point is lying on, instead of this, One point is origin. Suppose this is the point origin, this is y dash, this is x dash, and this is y, this is x axis, you know, and one point is origin, and this second point is x1, y1. Then what will happen? This coordinate is origin. Then in that case, if one point out of this x2, y2 is origin, in that case, 0 minus x1 whole square and 0 minus y1 whole square, then distance of point P from origin is x1 square plus y1 square under root. So distance of point from origin can be calculated like distance of point P, distance of point P xy, right, xy, say xy, not x1, y1, just because there is no two points, we can write just xy. Distance of point xy from origin is given by OP is equal to under root x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square, and what is that? That will come under root x square plus y square. So this is another formula. The distance of any point from origin can be calculated by using this x square plus y square. I hope you got this. X square plus y square will be the answer of this formula. So let me write some questions. I hope you got this. How this formula has been derived, that is the what I wanted to tell you, and so I have discussed. But no need to learn how it has been derived. This is just a conceptual approach. You have to learn these two formula, that distance of between two points can be calculated by using this, and on the basis of this formula we can find the distance of a point, any point from origin, or we can find the distance between two points also. So let us do some questions on the basis of this. So what are those questions? Try to understand. First question is, if 3, 2, A, 3, 2, B, 1, minus 4, and C, minus 3, 5, are 3 points lies in a plane, and represent as the vertices of a triangle.
B is 1, minus 4,
and C is 1 comma minus 4, and C is what? It is given minus 3 comma 5. So I can calculate the distance AB, and AB can be calculated like using this x1 minus x2 whole square or x2 minus x1 whole square. If I took this one x1 x2 and this is y1 y2, then there is no x1 y1 and x2 y2, or even this one is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2, it won't make any difference. So 3 minus minus 3, that will be plus 3 whole square, plus y2 minus y1, 2 minus 5 whole square. That can be written as 3 plus 3, 6 square, that is 36, and 2 minus 5 is minus 3, minus 3 whole square is 9, and therefore this is under root 45, that is 3 root 5. 3 root 5 is the distance of AB. The length of AB, AC I have calculated here first, AC has been calculated, that is 3 root 5. Now AB is equal to what? AB, again in the similar fashion I can write here, AB is 3 minus 1 whole square, 3 minus 1 whole square, plus 2 minus minus 4, that would be plus 4 whole square, 2 minus minus 4, minus minus plus. So it would be like 3 minus 1, 2, 2 whole square is 4, and 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 whole square is 36, so 36 plus this is 40, and 40 can be written as 2 root 10. 2 root 10, because 4 into 10, that is 2 root 10. And now BC can be calculated like using the same formula, minus 3 minus 1, minus 4 whole square, plus 5 minus minus 4, 5 plus 4, 9, 5 plus 4 whole square, that is 16 plus 9 whole square is 81, 81 plus 16 is 97, and none of them are equal. Even a squaring of any two is not equal to 3. So here we can easily write that since AB is not equal to BC, is not equal to CA, and neither such a relation exists that a square of sum of a square of two sides is equal to a square of third side, that is also not exist. So therefore neither it can be equilateral, nor isosceles, nor right angle triangle, and therefore this triangle is a scalene triangle, and therefore answer is D. D will be the appropriate answer of this question. Now let us discuss some other questions. I hope you got it. Distance formula to be applied. By finding the distance, we can find the length of the sides of triangle, and thereafter, after finding the length of the sides of triangle, we can analyze that whether this triangle is isosceles or equilateral or scalene or right angle triangle or anything else. So another question, let me write another question. Question number 2. Find the coordinate of the point. Coordinate of the point on x-axis. X-axis, which is at distance 5 unit from the point 3, 4. So to find the solution, find the coordinate of the point on x-axis which is at distance 5 unit from the point 3, 4. It means any point lie on x-axis. We have, remember this, what I have discussed? Any point lie on x-axis has y coordinate 0. So we can have y coordinate 0. Let x0 or k0, say k comma 0 be any point, let P, AK, 0 be any point on x-axis, at distance 5 unit from point, say name I can give it Q, 3, 4. So P is point on x-axis, Q is point somewhere in Cartesian system, that is in first quadrant, and distance between these two is 5 unit. So here PQ is equal to 5, that would be, therefore PQ would be 5. And PQ can be calculated by using the formula K minus 3 whole square, X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square is equal to 5. After squaring this, this will be K minus 3 whole square plus 16 is equal to 25. This implies K minus 3 whole square is equal to 9. 25 minus 16 is 9. And therefore K minus 3 is equal to plus minus 3. And in that case, K can have two values, 3 plus minus 3, which implies K is equal to either 0 or 6. So there would be two such points on x-axis. One is 0, 0. K, 0 and K, 0, 0, 0. So the points are 0, 0, even origin is also sufficient, and 6, 0 are the two points required. A similar type of question can be discussed, like here question number 3, find the coordinate of point on y-axis which is at distance 7 unit from point minus 3 comma 4 or minus 3 comma 7, because you will think that y always 3 4 3 4 3 4, so I have changed this point minus 3 comma 7. So here again you can write in the similar pattern. What will be that solution? Any point lie on y-axis, what will happen? Their x-coordinate will be 0, right? Now x-coordinate will be definitely 0. So let 0 P or 0 K, say like this, be any point on the y-axis, which is at distance 7 unit from point Q minus 3 comma 7, and therefore PQ must be equal to 7, which implies PQ is what? So minus 3 minus 0 whole square plus 7 minus K whole square is equal to 7. Now if I square both the sides, on squaring what will come, what will happen on squaring, that this will come 3 square minus 3 whole square is 9 plus 7 minus K whole square is equal to 49. So again I can write it, 7 minus K whole square is equal to 40, because 9 will go to that side, it will be negative, and in that case 7 minus K would be plus minus root under 40, and root under 40 is what? 2 root 10. So 7 minus K is equal to plus minus 2 root 10, and therefore K can be written as 7 minus plus 2 root 10, means there are two values, this will come this side, it will be plus minus would be minus plus, and K come this side, it will be positive. So there are two points here also, and therefore points are, there are two points, 0 comma 7 minus 2 root 10, another point is, or 0 comma 7 plus 2 root 10 are two points on y-axis, on y-axis. So you will be able to analyze this. This is the type of questions which can be generated and can be asked in your school examination. So you will be able to analyze like this. Let me discuss some more questions. So question number 4. Find the point on x-axis which is equidistant from points 3, 7 and -2, 5. There are two points and we have to find a point which is equidistant. Equidistant means equal distance. From these two points, they are equal distances. So by that point must lie on x-axis. Again, I can write here solution. Let k 0, because on x-axis y coordinate must be 0, be p k 0, p be any point, and the coordinate of that, let p k 0 be any point on x-axis, point on x-axis which is equidistant from q 3, 7 and r -2, 5. This is the name I have given. So p is distance of q from p and distance of r from p should be equal. So according to question, pq is equal to pr. Now, and therefore I can write here pq square is equal to pr square. And using the distance formula, since I have written in form of a square, so no need to write a square root sign. And now we can write here, pq is equal to k minus 3 whole square plus 0 minus 7 whole square. And pr can be also written in a similar pattern, k minus minus 2, that is k plus 2 whole square plus 0 minus 5 whole square. If you split them, that will be k square minus 6k plus 9 and minus 7 whole square is 49. Here again also k square plus 4k plus 4 and minus 5 whole square is 25. So k square cancels out. 6k will come this side, it will be 10k, you know, 10k. And this is 25 plus 4, 29. That will come this side, it will subtract. 49 minus 29 is 20. 20 plus 9 is 29. And therefore, k is equal to 29 by 10. So point will be 29 by 10, k comma 0. That is 29 by 10 comma 0. That is the point on what? X-axis. And this is the question which we can solve it by using this fact. Always point is lying somewhere on x-axis. Because it lies on x-axis, so their y-coordinate must be equal to 0. And since y-coordinate is 0, therefore format of the coordinate will be k, 0. And by finding this, pq is equal to pr, pq square is equal to pr square. And on the basis of that, because I have written squares here, so I haven't written here square root sign. And using the distance formula, I can evaluate the value of k. And that will be the right answer of the question. So sometimes there are the questions like where we can prove this, that points are collinear or not. So if points lie on a line, they are called collinear. So let me write one concept, collinear points. Collinear points. What are those? Collinear points. What are those? Collinear points. If three or more points lie on the same line, they are called collinear points. So if A, B, C are collinear, if three points A, B, C are collinear points, then there must exist a relation. Then there exists a linear relation like AB plus BC is equal to AC. Means sum of these two must be equal to third, then points are called collinear. Suppose A is here, B is here, C is somewhere here, then AB plus BC must be equal to AC, and if that relation exists, then points are considered to be collinear. So hopefully you understand collinear points, what are the collinear points, and now you have to analyze some questions. Let me discuss few questions which will be collinear or not, that you have to test it. So again, the distance formula will be the key point by which we can calculate this, right? So let us see the points are collinear or not. Okay, so how to deal with some other idea also in which we can test the collinearity of the point. If three points are given, say A, B, C are given, then by vector method we can solve also. By area of triangle, if area of triangle is zero, then also the points are collinear, because if they are lying on the same line, they cannot make a triangle, and on that way you are not able to find the area of the triangle. Area of triangle will be zero. So if points are collinear, means they lie on the same line, and by using distance formula we can calculate them. So collinear points are those points which lie on the same line. Also there is another similar term, let me introduce that one also, that is called coplanar points. And don't confuse about this coplanar points. The points which lie on the same plane. The points which lie in the same plane. Are called coplanar points. This is the additional information I am giving. It is not to be known in class 10th, and we can calculate them, this collinear points, coplanar points, by using the different ideas. So here we have not studied coplanar points, but because sometimes you don't confuse it with the collinear and coplanar points, so that is why I have given this definition. So finally we learn how to use the distance formula. What is the distance formula? What are the use of the distance formula? And on the basis of collinearity, we will discuss some questions in the next class. Thank you very much for watching. Again, we will cover all those topics, remaining questions, in the next class. So till then, keep watching.